properties on Banach algebras. The first property over here, link that with an inverse. So it says that if A is any complex Banach algebra having identity as E and we have some element X belonging to that algebra which satisfies the condition of norm of X less than 1, then we say E minus X is invertible and this inverse is calculated by the expression E plus summation XJ, where J now varies from 1 to infinity. Note here that the index for J starts with 1 and not from 0. This should be noted here. Okay, so if you remember, this theorem also replicates the result which we already have for operators, where the operator which is defined by I minus T inverse, that we already know was given by summation lambda J T raised to power J, something like this, right? So corresponding to this, we have a similar results for Banach algebras. So let's see the proof here. So here, because in Banach algebras we have the result norm of xy less than equal to norm of x norm of y, so therefore applying this result onto norm of x to the power j, now what is this thing? This is x multiplied to itself j times, and so we can apply this result onto this expression so that we have less than equal to norm of x j times. So we can write this quantity as x to the power j. So you have norm of x to the power j less than equal to the norm of x raised to power j, right? This result. So now what we are given? We are given norm of x less than 1. So therefore norm of x to the power j would obviously be less than 1. Why? Because this thing is less than this thing. And what is this thing? This is less than 1 to the power j, which is 1 only. So from here we have this result. And if this is the result, norm of j is less than 1. So therefore summation norm of xj would converge, because it would be an infinite GP series, geometric series, where the common ratio has magnitude less than 1. So therefore we say this series converges absolutely. Which series? The series given by star, this series. This converges absolutely whenever A is a Banach algebra, right? So now we consider the right hand side, which is E plus summation of xj's, to be the sum as S. Next we prove that this S, which is the right hand side of the equation star, is equal to the left hand side. So we prove that the inverse of E minus X is equal to S. So to show that, what we do, we multiply both of these so that we may get identity if both of these are the inverses of each other. So we consider E minus X into S. So this thing would be equal to S into E minus X. Why? Because we are now in the Banach algebra. So this thing is equal to this thing. However, we start from E minus X into S. Proceed like this. We have substituted the definition for S, which was E plus summation of XJ. So when you open up the summation of XJ, it would be this. And then this thing is equal to S into E minus X. So there is no problem. This term is what? This is your E minus X into S. And what is this term? This is S into E minus X. So now what you can do, you can multiply the individual terms. So you have E minus X from the first term. From the second term, you would have X minus X square. From the third, you would have plus X square minus X cube and so on. So you see all of these terms, they cancel each other. And you are only left with E minus X to the power N plus 1. So therefore, you obtain E minus X into S as equal to E minus X to the power N plus 1. Now, because the norm of X is given to be less than 1, so that means if you tend this n towards infinity, the norm of the norm raised to infinite power whenever it is less than 1 would obviously tend towards 0. This is quite obvious. So from here we can write e minus x into s as equal to s into e minus x as equal to e, right? Because this term now becomes equal to 0. So from this expression we can say that s is nothing but the inverse of e minus x. So this implies that the inverse of e minus x is given by this infinite series e plus summation j varying from 1 to infinity x to the power j. So this is our first important property corresponding to Banach algebras.